Today, I'd like to share a new TI design that will make an impact on the test and measurement market. Mainly targeted towards data acquisition systems, this design will maximize the system's effective number of bits, or ENOB, by eliminating unwanted noise generated by the power supply. DC to DC converters are commonly used for power regulation due to their improved efficiency over other power options such as the low dropout regulator, or LDO. However, these devices have harsh switching components which generate EMI that can be radiated or conducted through the system. The effects of EMI can be especially noticeable on very high resolution systems, such as this design, which uses the ADS8900B, a 20-bit, 1 megasample per second SAR ADC to digitize the input signal. This high resolution causes the system to have a noise floor of negative 140 dB. With this low noise floor, the EMI generated from the switching regulator can cause a major performance degradation to the signal-to-noise ratio, or SNR. In order to mitigate these effects of EMI, careful attention needs to be paid to the selection of the switching regulator. For this design, we chose TI's LM53635M-Q1 wide VN buck converter, which is able to reduce EMI in three ways. First, its hot rod packaging eliminates bond wire inductance, which reduces ringing on the switch node. Next, the device incorporates spread spectrum switching, which effectively spreads the switching noise over a wider frequency band. And lastly, with its symmetric pinout, the board layout of this device can be done utilizing symmetric current loops to help reduce EMI. In addition to these three features, the part is automotive qualified, so it's a perfect fit for automotive applications, and with its 2.1 MHz switching frequency, a smaller inductor can be used, making for a small overall form factor. We tested this part against one of TI's popular power modules, which does not have the same EMI reducing features as the LM53635. I am going to show you a side-by-side comparison of results gathered from doing a spectral analysis on the output of the ADC. The image on the left is the result when the other module is powering the system, and the image on the right is the result when using the LM53635 device. All the spurs caused by EMI are eliminated, which provides a performance improvement of over 1 dB in SNR and 14 dB in SFDR. Now we will see how the LM53635 fares against the ideal external power solution. Again, these results were gathered by performing a spectral analysis on the output of the ADC. On the left, we have the LM53635 results. And on the right, we had the results when using external power supplies to power the system. The results are identical, and the performance between the two is very comparable. This is a win for customers who have sensitive signal chains and want to reduce board space. As you can see, the TIDA-01054 is very compact and full of components, with the LM53635 devices placed quite near the signal path of the ADC. More test results can be found in the design guide by going to ti.com/tool/TIDA-01054. Thanks for watching.